Tap the subscribe button and hit the bell icon for notifications of the upcoming videos. The city of Lucknow is famous worldwide for its etiquettes and mannerism and is often referred to as the city of Nawabs. It has several big and small imambaras and is dotted with ancient buildings and old historical structures that narrate the stories of the Pagan era. One such imposing monument, the Chota Imambara or Imambara Husainabad Mubarak, is purely an architectural marvel. Located in the heritage zone of Lucknow, this monument is not very far off from Bara Imambara, and the Rumi Darwaza acts as a separator between the two. There are several other tourist attractions which one can visit on his way to Chota Imambara, like the Satkhanda Watchtower, the Picture Gallery, and the Clock Tower of Husainabad. It is said that the clock tower of Husainabad or Husainabad Ghantaghar was built in 1881 to mark the arrival of Sir George Cooper. It is the tallest clock tower in India and its clock was said to be imported from London. Little ahead of this clock tower is a ticking red-colored watchtower, Satkhanda, opposite to which stands the famed Chota Imambara. Chota Imambara is a beautiful monument that was built in 1838 by the third king of Awadh, Muhammad Ali Shah, and it serves as the resting place of the king and his mother. Upon entering through the main gate, the first thing that catches every visitor's attention is the golden fish mounted on the top of a triple arch gateway. Surprisingly, it's not a decorative piece, but it's a weather vane which shows the direction of the wind. You will also see golden statues of two ladies on either side of the gate holding an iron chain in their hands. If you look carefully, you will notice that the chains are attached to the lightning conductor, which absorbs the lightning current and passes it down to the statues for earthing. The other noticeable things inside the Imambara complex are its large golden dome and two replicas of the Taj Mahal on either side of the water channel, out of which one has the graves of Muhammad Ali Shah's daughter and her husband. It is said that the water for the fountains and the water bodies inside the Imambara comes directly from the river Gomti. The complex also sites a beautiful mosque, but sadly, non-Muslims are not allowed to enter inside. It also houses a Shahi Hammam, the bathing place for the Nawab and his family members. The interesting thing about this royal bath is that it has provisions for both running hot and cold water and has outlet drains connected to the river Gomti. The bath also has a bathtub, overhead shower panels, and a unique system of pumping water from a nearby well. Apart from the mosque, Shahi Hammam, and the replicas of the Taj Mahal, the main attraction of the complex is the Chota Imambara, which stands right in front of the water channel. It has intricate carvings and calligraphy of Quranic verses engraved on its outer walls. And there is no doubt that the white calligraphy against the black background makes the facade more beautiful and attractive. One can definitely spend a while enjoying the details of these carvings. The main hall of the Imambara has five doorways, which signify the Holy Five. As you step inside the hall, you will be amazed to see the treasures within. The interior is richly decorated with imported crystal chandeliers, colorful glass lamps, and gold-framed mirrors of different shapes and sizes from Belgium. It also has a few ceremonial taziyas on display and houses the crown of the Nawab. On the eve of special occasions, when the lamps and the chandeliers are lit, the Imambara looks gorgeous and it's a sight to behold. It's because of these stunning lamps and grand chandeliers that the Imambara got the name of Palace of Lights. Overall, it's a must-visit place for getting an insight of the Nawabi culture and heritage for which Lucknow is famous for. See you all in another interesting travel video. Till then, happy traveling and let's create lifetime memories.